Hello, Booblas, my darlings. How are you this morning? You hear the crows? We have a homeless cat that comes to eat, and so I put cat food out there. The crows come and eat all the cat food. I swear, but I adore crows. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Do blackbirds sing in the dead of night? I never heard it. I've been rereading a book that I'm very, very pleased to be in. Horror for the Holidays. Published by Miskatonic River Press. Miskatonic River Press will be bringing out my next book. Which maybe there's well, they're going to bring out some books by Joseph Pulver, A Season in Carcosa, which is a Robert W. Chambers tribute book, and then Puppets, which is a book of stories. Oh, my kettle came out. The Puppets is a tribute book to Thomas Ligotti, and they're both edited by Joseph Pulver, fantastic writer himself. So, hang on. I'm just getting some cappuccino. I got a little bit of coffee cream. Better. A little bit of water. Oi! I almost. My chair rolled away. I almost fell on the floor. I did that in one of my earlier videos. And I found it so humiliating that I deleted the video. I should have kept it because it was hilarious. I was trying to handle one of those huge Centipede Press books, The Masters of the Weird Tales. And I was standing up and I was trying to sit down and had turned. And the chairs are on rollers and I pushed away. Anyway, who cares? Dissecting Cluchlu, which is a book of essays edited by what's the guy's name? That guy, he can be so irritating in some of his opinions. Oh, S.T. Joshi. And the Dead But Dreaming anthologies, but most fabulous of all, oh, there we are, is Strange Dark One. It's a collection of my Tales of Nyarlathotep. It's coming out in October, but Horror for the Holidays. The lineup is wonderful. How can I do this? Am I doing this right? Can you all see? I'm so bad at this. Anyway, lots of wonderful writers. Tales of Rush. I wasn't certain about what to write for this book. And then, I learned about Oscar Wilde's tomb and how it's being smeared with lipstick kisses, and it's of great concern because the chemicals in the lipstick is eroding the stone of the tomb. And so I wanted to write a Jewish story for the book because I have Jewish heritage. And so I decided to write a story about the holiday Rosh Chodesh, which is a Jewish celebration of the moon. And the moon figures so potently in so much of what Oscar Wilde wrote. So my story is called The Tomb of Oscar Wilde. "Why did you bring me here?" I muttered, looking away from the grotesque defacement. "I find the sight exceedingly depressing. Please let us flee." But the poetess, who signs herself Seleno, merely laughed at what she saw as my dramatics. "Don't be absurd, Yakov. What you condemn as disfigurement are the authentic love tokens of countless admirers. To mar a poet's grave with graffiti is the opposite of admirable. How many of the fools who have pressed their painted lips against this tomb have ever read The Sphinx or The Harlot's House, or," and I pointed a long finger at her, "The Grave of Keats. If they want to pay homage to Wilde, let them write a poem, but to blemish his tomb in such a manner. I had heard about these ugly lipstick stains, but I had no idea there was such a plethora of them. They have marred this sacred place with their Judas mouths and killed the thing they love. Away, away." So, but there's the stories in this wonderful, wonderful book. There's Horrors of Valentine's Day by Oscar Rios and Brian Sammons. Brian is a superb writer. A Horror for Passover by Lois H. Gresh. Lois, darling, you're wonderful. There's, let's see, Horrors of Easter and the Angels Sing by Cody Goodfellow. He's just an amazing writer. The Last Communion of Alan Hill by Pete Rolick. And Pete's story is very, very Lovecraftian, and it's one of the best stories in the book. It's really good. It touches on At the Mountains of Madness. Very, very, he's really a good writer, Pete Rolick. Mr. Spriggs' Easter Attire by Joseph S. Pulver. I have to look at that because that's on one of the pages. Whenever Pulver's writing has a really, whenever I have a Pulver book, I'm compelled to read his prose aloud, because there is such beauty, terrible, terrible beauty in the prose of Joseph Pulver. This is a story that he wrote with Tara Van Flower. But it's Easter, night after an unbroken storm, first burst to cascade, that sheared and ate limbs and branches and roofs, roof tiles up and off, gone with the wind or to Oz. Night that put 2 inches of warm rain in the ground, night with a hide and seek moon stretching out its light in search of pearls and cracks. Pearls, P-U-R-L-S. Pearls and cracks and collisions. He's a poet. He's Joseph S. Pulver Sr. He's one of our finest writers because he writes so beautifully in his poetry, and yet his vision is so dark and twisted and brutal. So it's this amazing combination of its brutal beauty. It's just, there's no one like him in the genre today. He's just amazing. And let's see, what else do we have? We have A Horror for Mother's Day, Mother's Night by Anne K. Schwader, and who is one of our most magnificent poets. She has a poetry collection from Hippocampus Press that is just amazing. But her fiction is also, this is a poem. She has written, this is a sonnet by Anne. My moonlight lends the waves a spectral glow, akin to phosphorescence phantoms down beyond, a dark reef only locals know, which haunts the harbor mouth of Innsmouth Town. One night each year a shambling, shadowed horde assembles on the cobbles of this shore, to crouch in silence, faces turning toward those depths where ceremonies long before brought forth a strange deliverance or bane to mark their blood forever. Siblings all, they wait for her on whom their fathers called, a glory in the knowledge of her reign beneath immortal seas, where her embrace shall welcome every child of Hydra's race. Many of the items in this fabulous book are Lovecraftian to the core. That's a wonderful sonnet. Wow. Anne's poetry is just amazing. There's 4th of July, 4th of July, two 4th of July stories, one by T.E. Crow. Grau, honey, how do you pronounce your name? I'm so bad at pronouncing names. Is it T.E. Grau or T.E. Gray? You have to inform me. You have to educate me, my dear. And it's a very good story. On the 4th of July. Don Webb also has a story, Doc Gorman's Haunted Palace, which I believe pays tribute to Roger Corman. It's been a while since I've read this story. Don Webb is another fantastic writer. He and I were among the writers who wrote a Round Robin story that was published in Fantasy and Science Fiction, a story called Night Gauntlets. That was fun, and that's the only time I've ever been in FNSF, probably the only time I will ever be. Then there is A Horror for the Day of the Dead, El Dia de los Muertos by Kevin Ross. A Horror of Guy Fawkes Day by William Mickle. I've never had to try to pronounce all these names before. A Horror for Thanksgiving by Donald R. Burleson. Then Two Tales of Yule by Molly Burleson and by Tom Lynch, the publisher of the book. Horrors for Christmas by Joshua Reynolds, Thomas Ligotti, Letters to Santa by the editor Scott David Anowalowski, Keeping Christmas by Michael G. Zymanski, and The Nativity of the Avatar by Robert M. Price. I believe this is Tom Lynch's first published story. Tom's story. Wasail. I sat in the elder's longhouse, blinking back the irritation in my eyes from all the smoke. It felt like no breeze had been through in eons. The musty smell of old people, the tangy smell of sweat, and the thick smell of smoke filled the room. I decided I was going to do my best to breathe through my mouth. "Young one," the eldest said, "do you know why you are here?" He sat on the far side of the fire from me, in the middle of the other four elders. His face was stern and soft at the same time. "I confess I do not," I answered, looking at the five firelit faces. "Can you not guess?" barked the second, leaning his pitched face forward. "I assume you have a task for me." "You are special," said the eldest, placing a calming hand on the second. "Have you not been aware of this these years? You spent most of your time with us, learning of our beliefs and our history, while the other young men were learning to own their battle skills. You were pulled aside and taught about nature, planting, and the harvest, while the others your age were at the Beltane dances. You honored me with your teaching," I said quietly. Quite good writing for a first story, Tom. Tom is the publisher. He's the head chief of Miskatonic River Press, and he's a delightful publisher to work for, and I'm very grateful to him and the press for bringing out my next book in October. So I highly recommend Whore for the Holidays. It's a sumptuous collection of really good horror fiction, very good weird fiction. There's not a bad story in the book. Some of the writing is spectacular, and I'm really happy that I didn't know what to write for it, and I'm so glad that I came up with my story. And then they honored me by using my story as the opening story, which is always a nice honor to open an anthology. Doesn't happen for me very often, so I appreciated that. So I do encourage everyone to order Horror for the Holidays and to check out the other books from Miskatonic River Press. I shall provide a link down there in the description area of this blog, so that you can click on that and be taken to the Miskatonic River Press site. Instant presto. Gudiontif, my darlings. Have a wonderful day, and I shall see y'all later.